Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to print both the even and odd numbers by using for loop in Java. So let's get started. So first we will be getting the number n as an input from the user, till which we will be printing both the even and odd numbers. So for getting an input we will be using the scanner class. So just go to the top, it's going to be import java.util.scanner, and inside our main function it's going to be scanner input equal to new scanner, and inside that it's going to be system. Let me just remove this stuff dot in, and we will have our integer variable n equal to input dot next int, and don't use next line or next because that will take a string as input and we need an integer or a number. And before this, let me just have a print statement saying enter n. Yeah, this is better now. And let me just now have a simple for loop template, okay? And later I will explain you how you can modify this template. So it's going to be for int I equal to 0, I less than or equal to n, which is the number that we're getting as an input, I plus plus, and inside the for loop let me just print this. I'll just print I. So let me just now save this, and if I just now run this program, this will basically print all the numbers from 0 to our n. So if I give 10 here, you can see I'm getting all the numbers printed. But the thing is that we need to print only the even or odd numbers, okay? So first let me go with even numbers. So how this for loop works is that here you can see we are having the increment as I plus plus. So for each iteration, I value is incremented by 1. So basically this I plus plus is nothing but I equal to I plus 1. Alright. So first I value is 0. 0 gets printed. It goes here I plus plus, which is I equal to I plus 1. So I equal to 0 plus 1, which is 1. Then 1 gets printed. Then again goes here I equal to 1 plus 2, which is true. And 2 gets printed. Next it again goes here I equal to 2 plus 1, which is 3. 3 gets printed. It goes here I equal to 3 plus 1, 4 gets printed. So because of this, we are just incrementing by 1 and we are just printing it. That's the reason we were getting continuous numbers. So first thing, we need to change the initial value because 0 is not an even number, okay? 0 is a neutral number. So for printing the even numbers, we need to begin from 2 because 2 is the smallest and the first even number. And another thing, as I told you, here we are incrementing by 1, right? So if we increment by 2, we will be getting the even numbers alone. So first let me just show you and prove you that these both are same. So if I just copy and paste it, so I've just replaced I plus plus with I equal to I plus 1. So if I clear this and if I run it now, so enter n, I will just go with 10. So here you can see I'm getting the same output, so 2 to 10, because I plus plus and I equal to I plus 1 are same. So what if just I change this to I equal to I plus 2, that's it. So now this is going to be I equal to I plus 2, and what happens here is that during the first iteration I value will be 2, 2 will be getting printed. It goes here I equal to I's existing value is 2, so it's going to be 2 plus 2, which is going to be 4, and 4 gets printed, and it goes here I equal to 4 plus 2, which is 6, 6 gets printed. It goes here I equal to 6 plus 2, 8 gets printed. Then it goes here I equal to 8 plus 2, 10 gets printed, and this condition then satisfied, it becomes 12. After that I equal to 10 plus 2, 12, it is false and it just terminates. So we will be getting the even numbers at the end. So this is how a small change will help you to print the even numbers. So just have it I equal to I plus 2, and let me just now save this and clear this. So these are just commands, you can just remove this also if you want, saving it, and if you run it now, go with 10. So here you can see 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, I'm getting the even numbers. So for printing the odd numbers, we need to make a very small change, okay? Rather than having here the initial value of I to be 2, we can just have it as 1, that's it. So this will now print the odd numbers. So let me also explain the same. So I equal to I plus 2, and this is the output. So initially I value is 1, 1 gets printed, I equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3, 3 gets printed, I equal to 3 plus 2, 5 gets printed, and this just goes on till our n value. This n, the condition still satisfies or not, it goes on. So this is the thing, if you change this to 2, it will be even numbers. If you change this to 1, it will be odd numbers. So basically the initial value determines the type of numbers that we are printing. Okay, hope that made sense, because we are just using the same variable. And the fact is that if we add 2 to an odd number, it will give us the next odd number. For example, if I add 1, the next odd number to 1 is 3, and I'm getting that by adding 2. Exactly same thing with even numbers. If I add 2 to an even number, I'll be getting the next even number. So 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6. So that logic we are making use of over here to print the consecutive odd numbers till our number n. So this is fine. Let me just now run this and check if you are getting the odd numbers. Let me go with the same 10. Here you can see I'm getting 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Alright. And for printing both the odd and even numbers at the same time, you can just copy this. And let me just paste it here, and I will just have it as j equal to 2 over here, because we cannot use the same variables over there. So just replace everything with j in the second for loop that we are having here also j. So since j is equal to 2, this will print the even numbers, and here I equal to 1, this will print the odd numbers. And let me just now copy this, paste it. I'll just go with odd, and this is going to be even. Yeah, saving it, and if I run it, I'll go with 15. So here you can see 1 3 5 7 9 11 13 15, and even numbers are getting printed below that. So this is the program, and I hope you would have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in Java, C, C++, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, Grid Operations. Check them out. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.